Make sure you guys smash that subscribe button if you guys are fans of the content being posted onto this channel to always be in the loop with more content similar to this, and be sure to hit the video up with a like if you're enjoying the content. And with that being said, let's begin. With Capcom's blockbuster Resident Evil 8 looming over the horizon, rumored to be released in 2021, many fans within the Resident Evil community are seemingly enough divided following the initial leaks on the title itself, and within the next couple of weeks, there are rumors going around that we are going to be seeing our very first glimpse of Resident Evil 8, perhaps maybe somewhat of a teaser, somewhat of a trailer, provided given a poster, and this was originally due to the scheduled idea before COVID-19 that Resident Evil 8 was supposed to be revealed sometime between June and July of 2020, and with those dates right around the corner, we may in fact actually be getting our very first look at what Resident Evil 8 could be, which is essentially a good thing. But the reason why the fandom is seemingly divided is based on the overall leaks of course, Dust Golem. We understand the fact that this game is going to divide the community now more so than ever, and that's given its narrative, its direction, the occultism, the werewolf-like creatures, the witch that's going to be stalking you, and the return of Ethan Winters. And many people within the fandom aren't really too fond of Ethan only because there seems to be a lack of development, there seems to be a lack of story building surrounding the character, and I think that I speak on behalf of many people when I say that Ethan's character needs to develop fully within Resident Evil 8 to get people to actually care enough to invest in the character. Otherwise, the character is going to be dead and gone within the waters before the game is even released. Now, because of this, we also understand that Chris Redfield is going to play a major role in the game. Now, what exactly is his role going to be? We don't know. But along with Resident Evil 8, there are many rumors going around about a potential new Silent Hill game. So the horror franchise is now beginning to pick up the pace and kind of go back and giving us nostalgia titles such as Resident Evil, Silent Hill. But the one quality about Resident Evil that a lot of people seem to gravitate towards and kind of latch onto is the overall depth and analytical analysis that the game gives us with characters, world building, story building that the previous titles such as Resident Evil 0, Resident Evil 1, 2, 3, and so on have provided throughout the years. Now, Resident Evil 8 is also going to feature a split cutscene mode where it's going to include first-person and third-person perspectives, which means that for the first time, we may actually be getting a little reveal as to what Ethan looks like, and perhaps maybe the situation he's involved in involving Chris Redfield and his overall surroundings, which also happen to include the witches, zombies, and wolf-like monsters that Ethan is going to be facing. Which at the same time, Resident Evil 8 is shaping out to look a lot like Outlast 2 in a sense to where the occultism is going to play a heavy factor in this game, considering the idea of Ethan having to go overseas, venture out into these villages, and come across these castles, all to be pursued by enemies of unknown origin, essentially. And even though we all are getting Resident Evil 4 vibes in a sense to where it kind of feels similar to Leon going out into Europe to look for Ashley, we don't know what exactly Ethan is doing in this remote part of Europe where it's cold and the environment may in fact be snowy and arctic in nature. But even then, with the game having to introduce elements in being one of the most violent entries in the series thus far, I have high hopes in a sense to where they remove the molded from Resident Evil 7 in providing us and giving us different kinds of variety of enemies such as zombies, but these zombies are going to be so different by comparison to what we've seen before. It really makes the viewer wonder as to what kind of zombies these are going to be. Are they going to be crimson head-like zombies to where they're going to be constantly pursuing you? Are we going to have rage-like infected zombies to where there is no ending in sight and they're going to pursue you in massive hordes? Are we somehow going to be getting the introduction of somewhat of a regenerative zombie? We don't really know, but right now what is known is that Ethan Winters' story is going to continue following the events of a rumor of Ethan and Mia finally having a child, and perhaps maybe this has something to do with the tie-in narrative with Chris Redfield and the concept idea of Ethan having to go to Europe. And I think that Capcom heavily knows and has paid attention to the fan feedback in a sense to where the fans want to keep the same element as Resident Evil 7 in a sense to where it's horror-based and it's not really based on action, or it's not really based on a Call of Duty-esque kind of style, but more or less wanting the game itself to be mostly grounded on survival horror. And the one thing we won't be getting, sadly enough, in this game is the introduction or the reintroduction of the concept of puzzles and the game having to mainly focus on puzzle solving. That really isn't going to be a driving force in the game. They are going to have some puzzles in the game, but they're not going to be anything like we've seen in Resident Evil 1, Resident Evil 2, Resident Evil 3. So if you're someone that has high hopes for puzzle solving or having a constant basis of trying to always figure things out in the game in a sense to where you have to figure out these puzzles, then you're going to be disappointed because those elements aren't going to be heavily driven in the game. But at the same time, what a lot of people are actually hoping from the game itself is for us to actually explore the environments within the game and not giving us an RPG sense to where we have this big open world so we can go wherever and do whatever we want, but more or less in a sense to where we want to be able to do what we did in Resident Evil 4 and Resident Evil 5, and that's explore villages, explore the castle, explore different kinds of elements that are introduced within the game, actually similar to Resident Evil 1's remake on the GameCube, and follow that formula to where it allows us to bounce back and forth. It actually allows us to transcend environments and actually try to explore different kinds of elements within the game rather than having everything based on a very linear structure to where it's very one-directional and as soon as you go forward, there's no way you can move back. So I think with Resident Evil 8, that incorporation is going to be heavily focused in the fact that there are going to be countless amounts of enemies pursuing you, different kinds of enemies, and their overall designs are also said to be some of the most terrifying in the series, which again, you have to take into consideration the hunters, the lickers, the Cerberus dogs, the crimson heads, the tyrants, and all of the enemies we've seen, the regenerators, the chainsaw-wielding maniacs, and everything in between. To take into account that there are going to be enemies in this game that are going to be much more violent and more terrifying than the others really gives me hope in a sense to where Ethan in this scenario is really going to have his back up against the wall unless Chris Redfield is going to play a big role in further assisting Ethan throughout his journey and getting him to where he wants to be. Which at the same time, it's kind of interesting because Chris Redfield was said to be written in the game to be a lot different than the original Chris that we know of. Perhaps maybe he's going to be an adversary to Ethan. Maybe we are going to have a major character death in this game because honestly speaking, I do think that's what's needed and we are going to basically talk more about this in the next video in the fact that this upcoming game needs to feature a major character death only because you need to establish tension, you need to establish a sense of desperation, you need to establish an organization that can actually finish the job rather than constantly making mistakes or at least being very negligent with their approach. So I think that with Ethan, he could be used as a leverage character to fill in for an older character and basically having to make room for the future. So this really all does boil down to so many factors, and I think that the game itself does deserve a chance, and it's going to be the quote most terrifying addition within the series thus far. It could be rhetoric from Capcom, but then again, I really do have high hopes only because the game could actually be delivered in such a great way, or there's that chance that the game could ultimately flop, and this could end up being the absolute worst Resident Evil game in the franchise thus far. Which right now, this could end up being a complete hit or miss, but I think that every single Resident Evil fan needs to give this game a chance, especially by seeing what they're going to do with Ethan's character, because Resident Evil 8 is really going to come down to execution, and if they don't execute on the character itself along with the story and the gameplay and the narrative, then the game is going to be a complete flop. But by the end of all of this, I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below about Ethan's direction and what you guys personally believe Ethan's direction should be in Resident Evil 8, if by some chance he should have somewhat of a pairing with Chris, if he should be opposed to Chris, and also when looking at the overall game's elements for the survival horror aspect, the action aspect, do you guys think that at some point the game should introduce a small dose of action just to give Ethan a boost against said enemies, or should the entirety of the game not feature any action element but instead just keep it solely grounded on survival horror and survival horror only? Again, Thank you all so much for your time. Thank you all so much for watching. Hopefully enough, in the next couple of weeks, we are going to see somewhat of a reveal or somewhat of a trailer, because Capcom does in fact, or did, have a big reveal plan for 2020 involving Resident Evil 8. And given the fact that Resident Evil 8 originally was going to be a completely different title than what we know of right now, it's most interesting to see their overall narrative being changed and their overall direction being changed. But hopefully enough, we are going to be getting more information soon, so be on the lookout for that. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys are new, hit that subscribe button, guys. Give this video a big thumbs up if you guys are simply stoked, ready, and excited for Resident Evil 8. Tune back in for the next video, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Take it easy, guys, and have a great day. Peace.